So here we go at the autobahn.
It has frameless windows.
Four exhausts, fake exhausts, tips, yay.
Go away, lane departure.
More black and gray.
It's not super quick, but it gets there quite easily.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we are driving the all new 2018 Audi Q8 50 TDI. And that means that we've got a 3-liter V6 turbo diesel engine with 286 horsepower and 600 newton meters, which is, well, sufficient. Let's call it sufficient. It is quite nice to drive. But what's even nicer is the spec and the Q8 in general, because I think this is the most successful rendition of the SUV, coupe SUV, whatever, that you can buy right now. I think it's better looking than the BMW X6, Mercedes GLE Coupe. I mean, this sort of works. The proportions are right. It is very chunky. It is wide. It is muscly. I really like it. And I also really like these rear lights. As you can see, it has sort of an animation matrix LED, which I think is a bit look at me, but when they're on with that bar going across and those lights, I really, really like the look of it. And especially in this color, because this is Galaxus blue. I hope you can see this on camera, but there's actually a bit of green in there, and when the light hits it, when the sun hits it, it gets this really nice green shine. It's absolutely gorgeous, especially in combination with all those black details. So we've got an all black grille, black in the bumper, lights as well. I think we've got these 22-inch wheels, which are really nice Audi sport wheels, S-line package, black roof rails, black window frames, well, not frames because it has frameless windows, a black stripe down there, and at the rear we've got this black spoiler extension and black exhaust tips. I mean, there are like four on each side. 1, 2, 3, 4 exhaust, fake exhaust tips, yay, on each side. And a black bumper, and this is black too. Yeah, this bar, which is sort of Audi Quattro inspired. I think, you know, Audi also says that the sort of squareness and the chunkiness of this car has been inspired by the Ur Quattro, which I think is a lot of marketing, but I get why they say it. So the trunk. The Audi Q8 is the flagship right now. So it is more expensive than the Q7, but you can get the Q7 with 7 seats and the Q8 only with 5 seats. But it does have a nice boot, and it also has these buttons right here with which you can lower or lift the rear end, so it's easier to load your stuff in there. So it auto levels now. Back seats, you guys want to see the back seats maybe? Again, frameless windows, really nice. And as you can see, it has acoustic glass. So it is two layers with something in the middle. And rear leg room is actually really good. Oh, it's cold. And these seats are also adjustable, as you can see. And I don't know if the backrest is, yeah, backrest as well. So, not bad, not bad at all. So we've got Alcantara, brushed aluminium, black leather with sort of cloth, because we've got the S-line stuff. So we've got a more sporty look in here. And at the front, more black and gray and silver from the aluminium, of course. This car also has the heating, so you can, you know, set this for every day when you're driving to work, like set it at 7 a.m. for 30 minutes. And then when you leave at 7:30, it's hot. So auxiliary heating, I think it's called in English. Really nice. I actually used it this morning. We've got a panoramic roof, of course. So this car, just to give you an idea, this car starts at 109,000 euros in the Netherlands, and this one is 148,000. So there are a lot of options on this car. You know, a lot of driver assistant systems. We're doing a review on the new A6 2018 model, which will come out later, I think. And I talked about the driving aid systems a lot in that one. So I'm not going to do that here. I don't really like it. That's the gist of it. So I usually just turn them all off. We do have the four-wheel steering, which I really like, because it gives this car sort of a very agile and very nice feeling when you're driving it. It really helps in sort of shrinking this car down. It also has a 48 volt mild hybrid system, which means that if I go to, let's go to efficiency mode. So if I release the throttle somewhere along here, it should turn it off. No, it should go into coast mode and switch off the engine entirely. Oh, and lane departure. Go away, lane departure. Don't want you. Okay, so the 48 volt system has a lithium ion battery, and it has regenerative possibilities. So basically it's a start stop plus system, which means that it has a coast mode. So you let off the throttle, it turns off the engine. When you get to like a red light, you release the throttle and it switches off the engine and lets you roll forward, and it should save around 10% in fuel economy. So that's nice. Audi has clearly tried to make this, you know, a very sporty rendition of an SUV. It looks the part, but does it drive the part? So we're going to switch to dynamic mode. The air suspension lowers by 40 millimeters, which is a lot. There's also an off-road setting which raises the air suspension by 50 millimeters. So there's 9 centimeters of air suspension travel, which is quite a lot actually. Driving wise, the car feels really light. It weighs over 2100 kilos, so it's not a light car, but it does feel really great. The steering is a bit disconnected. I thought it would get heavier in dynamic mode, but it's still very, very light. There's not a lot of communication going on. We've got an 8-speed automatic gearbox, which is really nice as well. It can be a bit sluggish if you drive it in comfort mode, but all in all, it is really nice. I did, however, expect a little more performance from a 50 TDI. As I said, it has a 3-liter V6, turbo diesel, 286 horsepower, 600 newton meters, 0 to 100 kilometers an hour, 6.3 seconds. Top speed 245. I don't know, it doesn't feel that, oh, that's my bad, I'm still in manual mode. It doesn't feel that torquey, so this is always a nice test. Going in here really quickly, there we go, a little bit of understeer, but that is impressive for a car this heavy. I mean, you can carry a lot of speed. That was really nice. That was actually really good. So here we go at the Autobahn. And that engine is actually really quiet. And something else which is really impressive is that even though we've got frameless windows, it's still relatively quiet. at higher speeds. Brakes are very nice too. Nicely judged brake pedal, feels really good. So an SQ8 is probably inevitable with the 4-liter V8 TDI. I don't actually know. No, I don't know if it's inevitable because Porsche has stopped producing that engine. So maybe Audi is not going to do that engine either. But an RSQ8 has been spotted at the Nürburgring, probably with the RS6 engine, 4-liter V8 biturbo with 605 horsepower, I think. So that is definitely coming, and that we're definitely going to drive that one. Should be really cool. Sort of a Lamborghini Urus, but then from Audi, which the Urus also is. But as you can see, I mean, it's not super quick, but it gets there quite easily. 239. Should be able to do 245, but we'll see. But that air suspension is really nice as well. It's really stable, soaks up all the bumps. Yeah, it is a very good car, this. I really, really like it. So this car also has the B&O audio system. It has a lot of cool features that you might not need. So that's also why it is so very expensive. And basically, this is the SUV version of the A8. So this has to be the most luxurious version, the most, well, the most coveted version as well. People have to look at this car and think, oh wow, look at that. And well, they have got me, because when I first laid eyes on this new Q8, I thought, what a looker. And now, you know, driving it, you can feel that a lot of clever stuff is going on underneath to make sure that this car handles the way it should. It's a very heavy car, it is high up, but you know, that Quattro system with torque vectoring is usually set to 40% front, 60% rear, but it can send way more to the rear, and it will. It has torque vectoring, it has a center differential that manages the power too. It is, you know, it is the flagship with a reason, and you really feel that in here. Next year, 2019, will also bring a 45 TDI with 231 horsepower and a 55 TFSI with 340 horsepower, so that's a petrol engine. And as I said, an RSQ8 is definitely coming. An SQ8, I don't know, we have to see if Audi is going to continue that 4-liter V8 TDI engine. I don't know. So for now, this 50 TDI is the only one available. And you know, if you're going for a diesel, I would definitely recommend getting this one, because I think, you know, if you get 231 horsepower, I think it's going to feel a bit heavier. I think this is okay, but any less horsepower and torque than this, it's going to feel heavy. So that's it for the German Autobahn, and that's it for this review. I hope you enjoyed it, guys. You can subscribe by clicking the big button right here. Please do, and don't forget to turn on notifications if you do. You can also check out this POV review of an Audi SQ7, and you can check out this POV review playlist. We've made a lot of them, so go check it out and follow us on social media. Thanks, guys. See you at the next one. Bye.